Hey, welcome to our show, guys. Hey, we got a dandy show planned for you today. And guess where we are, Bryce?
Looks like we're in a barn.
We are in a barn, and that barn is in Salem.
All right.
Our topic today, we're going to be talking about farriers.
What? Fairies?
No, Bryce, not fairies, not Tinkerbell.
Oh.
Blacksmithing, things like that. A farrier means they shoe horses.
They what?
Shoe horses.
Okay.
And we got a dandy farrier here today as our guest, so we're going to bring him in right now. This is Rory Ripple, right?
Yes, sir. Uh-huh.
He doesn't look like a fairy.
Ooh.
What happens if you call him that?
Goose? I don't know. Yeah.
I dare you, Goose.
You're not a fairy, are you?
No. Fairy-er. Heavy on the er.
All right. Okay, we've got another guest here today. Her name is Becky.
Becky Oldham.
Let's get her on the show here today. Right here, Bryce. Welcome to our show.
Hi.
And why are you here today?
To get my horse shod by Rory.
Is he one of the best?
He is.
He is the best. Okay, we're going to go back. And what's the name of this horse?
Business.
And how did you get that name?
When people call to ask where my husband is, we can say he's out on business.
Business, I love that, don't you? I love it, man. All right, folks, we're going to go back here. And first step, Rory, what's the first step?
The first thing you want to do is look at the horse and analyze its conformation, look at its balance. That horse is a little bit, easy girl, she's a little bit towed out, just a little bit, but you can see her knee here is a little bit pointed out that way.
Right.
So she's not dead on straight, but no horses and no people are straight.
Okay.
That's what we try to do is shoe them in balance so that they break over straight and hit flat.
I got you.
George, is that true? No people are ever straight? Has anyone ever called you George Straight?
Oh, that's another good one.
Well,
we'll get to George Straight later, right?
Promise?
I promise.
All right.
Okay, so it's like when our nails get a little long, Bryce, you know?
Do you go to a farrier to get your nails done?
I don't go to a farrier, no. I do my own.
Glad to hear
it. All right, so we're going to go over here.
Look how he did that, Goose.
And now the tool, what's the name of this tool? What are you doing here?
Hoof tickle, we're cleaning the hoof out, getting all the debris and dirt out.
Hoof tickle?
Pick.
Oh, pick.
A hoof pick.
It probably does.
My hoof pick is an old knife.
Okay.
An old shoeing knife.
I got you.
You want to have knives as sharp as you can get them. Sharp knives make easier work. Or sharper knives.
Okay, now I want to know, and our people probably want to know, why does a horse have to even be shod?
To protect the sole of the foot, keep it from getting sore. If you walk barefoot all day, you'd get sore.
I got you.
Same with a horse. They walk barefoot, they'll get sore. But a horse will wear away the sole of its foot. They'll wear that away, and they'll wear it down to the point that they will get sore. They'll get tender. By putting the shoe on, you keep the hoof from being wore out and wore down to the tender spot where it gets sore.
Okay, now a couple weeks ago when I was here, you was giving me the names of the hoof. Can you name the parts of the hoof for the people?
On the bottom part here, we've got just the sole of the hoof, and right here is what we call the frog.
Frog?
Yeah.
Look at this. Frog? You mean that kind of frog?
It's similar to that frog.
Similar to that kind of frog.
It sounds the same, but sometimes I guess it looks the same.
Now, if this was a Geico commercial, this is the money you could be saving with Geico.
If you shod your horse, correct.
Right, Rory?
Right.
All right, now we're using the rasp, right?
Yes, sir. You want to rasp that foot flat.
Well, I've got to get in character here, Rory.
Ah. Holy cow, you're not in character.
There we go.
Slide me that hoof stand, will you?
The hoof stand. Gotcha.
Perfect.
All right, bud.
Thanks.
Yep. Oh, wow. Wait a minute. Boy, you ever do that? Knock off your lead?
Yeah, all the time. Easy trigger.
I think he's flipped his lid a few times here, shodding horses.
Okay, usually people are really concerned about price.
Uh-huh.
So
65 at my barn.
65?
Uh-huh. 75 at your barn for shoes.
Per?
Oh, per shoe?
No.
Oh, for four?
Yeah. To have your horse shod at $65 here. If you want me to come out to you at 75.
Okay.
I think that's a good deal, Goose.
That is a good deal. I wonder what they charge at the manicurist, the pedicurist.
I think it's at least that much for a pedicure.
And I wonder if they're as cute as Rory. Aren't they?
Is that the important thing?
Is that important?
Yes, oh, absolutely.
That's how Rory gets all the business.
Okay, now, what are we doing here?
Making this foot nice and round. Nice and smooth, try to make it match the hairline because the hoof grows from the hairline down.
Uh-huh.
So the end of the bottom of this hoof should look like that hairline there.
Oh.
And when the hoof grows down, sometimes it grows out. And if it does grow out, we want to push it back so that it's straight. Try not to have any daylight, a straight line.
Oh, I see that.
See that?
Beautiful.
We're straight right here.
Uh-huh.
We're straight over here, but we could go maybe a little bit more right here.
Okay.
Not much more.
Gotcha.
But I think that right there will probably work for this horse.
Now, do you ever get a horse that isn't this cooperative?
Yes.
And then what do you do?
You use the magic word.
And what is that?
Glue.
Glue?
Glue. Whisper glue in their ear and they have a tendency to be real good.
Oh. So, if I'm reading you right, you can glue shoes now?
No, that's not what he's talking about. He's
what
talking
do they
about
make
the
glue out of?
Oh, I got it. Yeah.
Dead horses.
Oh no! Good one. You don't want to be glue, do you?
Ooh.
No, you don't want to be glue. Boy, this horse is being great, Bryce.
Well behaved.
I mean, I've had my head right up near the horse's nostrils. Oh, that's a good pair of
nippers.
Nippers. Now, Rory.
Yes, sir.
My buddy across the road, old Brent Jackson, wanted me to ask you this question. He loves horses and he knows horses.
Mm-hmm.
He wants me to ask you this question. Can you use a regular nail to put a shoe on?
No, you got to have a regular horseshoe nail, yes.
Can't use a roofing nail, I guess.
Okay.
What you're looking for here, you see that little bit of taper right there?
Mm-hmm.
That helps drive the nail out. That little bit of taper right there.
Oh, so you want
the side with the ruff, the buttons on it, is the side that goes to the inside.
Okay.
And the reason that it's built this way is because that way it will fit the shoe. It'll seat down in that hole. You want it to seat in there.
Look at that.
And one of the reasons why you want to get a good seat and get that nail in there tight, because every time a horse walks and steps, he moves the shoe.
Oh.
Which when you move the shoe, you wiggle it loose.
Okay.
That's why you want a good tight fit on the shoe, a good flat fit with the shoe, and a good seat with the nail. Make that fit.
Now, another question he wanted me to ask you is that some shoes, I think he called it a crop.
Mm-hmm.
A crop on?
Mm-hmm. Cork, heel and toe.
Cork, that's it, corks.
Mm-hmm.
And why does a shoe have to have a cork?
Well, the original purpose of heels and toes, they call them, cork shoes, was long before automobiles. And it's what that toe grab is on there for. In fact, I have one. I got
okay.
one right here.
Beautiful.
We're learning.
We are learning. Those are good questions, Brent. Thanks for cluing me in, man.
It's what that toe grab on there on your cork is what that
there
originally is built and designed for is for pulling. A horse can dig in with that toe and he can pull.
Oh.
It gives him traction for pulling. And these corks is what they're originally designed for, is backing up. If you've got a heavy wagon and loaded a freight and you need to back it into a dock, which they did have docks and unload back in the day, those corks help that horse get traction when he pushes down.
Oh.
The original design of the heels is for backing up, and the original design of that cork is to go forward for pulling. When you go to the store and you buy keg shoes, prefab shoes, it's called keg shoes, they all have four holes in them. You use four holes, four nails.
All right.
A smaller shoe, the smallest shoes, pony shoes will get into three holes, and a triple aught size shoe will just get into three shoes.
Yeah, aught and
aught, triple aught being the smallest, double aught, one, twos, threes, fours, and on out.
Beautiful.
The most common shoe used around here every day, average horse wears an aught, I would guess. I go use more aughts than I do anything.
Gotcha. Okay, we're going to take our first break right here, Bryce.
I want to know first, Those double-aught shoes you're wearing?
No, those aren't double-aught.
Oh, okay.
So when we come back, we're going to go over to this machine right here where you fire them up.
Uh-huh.
What's it called?
Forge.
We'll be back in just a minute. Hey, welcome back. We're going to go over to the forge now. But before we crank up the forge, Rory, about your dad, briefly.
Mm-hmm. Well, I got started. Dad was a trainer, is a good horseman and a good trainer. When I was a kid, I was about 6 years old, I went out and Dad was shoeing a horse, and I just thought that was neat. And he let me pick up a foot that day and actually try to trim it and try to shoe it. I couldn't do it. I wasn't big enough, strong enough.
So you were only 6 years old?
Yeah, and he gave me a hoof pick to start cleaning horses' hooves. So I'd go out every day and clean horses' hooves, and when I got big enough physically to do it, I went ahead and started trimming and started shoeing.
And that's where it began.
That's where it got started, yeah.
Beautiful. All right, we're gonna go to the forge now and show people how you crank this baby up. How hot does this forge get?
I really don't know. It gets hot enough to melt steel. It'll melt. So I just gotta get 1,800 degrees.
And so how long will you keep the shoes in there? Until they're hot enough?
Until they're red.
I called you last night to let you know what time we were coming this morning.
Yes.
And your kid said, that wasn't Goose.
We just so happened to be watching Goose in the Wild when you called.
Okay, and so this is for Cash, Chance.
Carden. Leslie.
And your wife was there.
Yeah.
Her name's what?
Leslie.
Leslie.
And Leslie.
That's my wife's name.
Really? Hey, that's a great name, Leslie.
Yeah.
Both Leslies. So that was really the Goose, and this is proof. Here's Dad, and here's your hubby right here. Is he doing a great job today?
You know, I hope he had a bet on this first, because he just won the bet.
He did. Did you have a bet?
No, we didn't bet. Yes, we did. Cash bet me $5.
$5, baby. You owe Dad $5.
Five biggins.
All right. Are our shoes just about ready? It smokes like you've never seen. And boy, and it smells like you know what.
Saying that ever since I've known you, this time it's appropriate.
Wow.
Holy smoke.
How long does it take you to put four shoes on?
It averages 45 minutes to an hour. The fastest I ever shoed a horse was 15 minutes.
Wow.
The most I ever done in a day was 13.
Wow.
You want to pick a foot up and try it?
Let's see.
Yeah. That'd be
fun. Oh, that's pretty cool.
In fact, if you stick it right between your legs and
between my legs?
Yeah. Here, grab it this way. With this hand. Now step over your hand.
Step over my hand?
So you can get your leg over there.
Like this?
Uh-huh. Now reach in, grab with this hand, grab that foot.
Like this?
Let go.
Oh.
Now reach in there with that hand, grab it.
Oh, grab this hand.
Yeah, there you go.
Wow.
Get a bottom leg. He can get a bottom leg here. He stacks him up. He's got a lot.
He needs a count right here, Al.
Yeah, he can just get a... He's got to put that head in the side. There you go. Now, you can get him turned.
He's got plenty of time if he can just work this.
hey, this is hard work, guys.
I think Rory could have been a wrestler in his day.
Oh, this is hard work. I always wondered why these farriers are stout. Would you say you're a stout guy?
No, no, I wouldn't say I'm stout.
You have a good, you'll be good in arm wrestling?
No.
I think you would be.
No. I think you would, man.
No, if there's a fight, scream like a girl and run. No.
Scream like a girl and run. Okay, yeah. I'm going to scream like a girl and give this hoof back to you. Ah!
Okay. Got her.
You got her?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
How's your back there, Goose?
Oh, wow. Hey, guys, I have a new respect for farriers. I do. Hey, what are you doing now, bud?
So what we're going to do is we're going to finish the shoe just before we nail it on. Is what we want to do is we want to put it here in our shoe holder, just like that. Is what we want to do, we'll take and knock the sharp edges off there. That kind of helps if the shoe gets caught or snagged, if the horse steps on the shoe, it'll help glance off.
We're going to go put this on him.
Okay, let's see it.
That will work?
Yeah, put it on him.
Okay, let's go. Oh, that's the hot one, isn't it?
Yeah, it's hot. Don't touch it.
God, yeah.
I don't know. I think we're going to need a bigger shoe here for this old horse.
Okay. A bigger shoe.
It'll be a triple lock.
No, bigger is one, twos, and threes. Triple smalls. We need to go bigger.
All right.
Got to have a bigger gym shoe here, Goose.
Okay.
We're not going to get it on.
All right. Sorry, guys. My bad.
Oops. I think we got this shoe to fit. Finally. Let me try it.
Now, is there a certain hole that you start in?
No. It doesn't matter what hole you start in. Personal preference. Some farriers will drive a nail all the way in, and they'll start at the front. I'd like to start with two nails, try to get that shoe to keep from moving.
Okay, now right here it's come out the side.
Uh-huh, it's supposed to.
It's supposed to.
Uh-huh.
So if it doesn't come out the side?
Then you know it didn't come out and it's supposed to. It went straight up all the way in.
Can you draw blood on a horse?
You bet.
And is that,
and draw blood.
Is that bad?
Yeah, that's bad. That's called getting inside the white line or nailing into the quick.
Oh.
You don't want to do that. You want to see the white line?
Yeah.
There. Can you see that white line?
Oh, yeah.
That line?
Right there.
If you get inside that line, you get into live tissue. And they get into the quick right there.
Mm-hmm.
So you got to make sure your nails are outside the white line.
Oh.
Towards the outside of the hoof there. When you drive your nails in, make sure you're outside the white line.
I didn't know that. Did you, Bryce?
No. That's kind of a small target.
We want a good full fit. The bigger the shoe, the more support for the foot. You can see we got a little bit of heel expansion right here. The shoe's a little wider than the foot.
Uh-huh.
And the reason that we want that is because when a horse walks and puts his weight on there, the heels will expand and contract. And we want plenty of room for that heel to expand and contract. The heels expand, go down, hit the frog, and the frog helps to pump the blood in the hoof.
So the frog is actually the heart of the hoof.
Right, kind of like.
Heart, pump the blood.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, see? The frog is the heart of the hoof.
Now, looks like everything is set. Ahead.
How easy that comes off, guys. Now, do you do this full time?
Yes. I'll try to shoe some horses every day so I can come home. If I don't have money, at the end of the day, my wife won't let me in the house.
So, for a young kid that's watching you do this?
Her name must be Leslie.
It is.
Watching you do this?
Uh-huh.
Is this a good way to make a living?
Oh, you bet. You get serious, go to the right instructors, get some good schooling behind you, learn about horseshoeing, learn about horseshoeing business. I know farriers that have a six-figure income off this business.
Six figures?
Uh-huh. Yep.
Six figures, guys.
want to clean our nails off, clean under the nails. The reason we clean under the nails is to get any hoof out from under there. We want a good, tight clinch.
So you're saying if you left those dangling out there, he'd catch on things, right?
Well, it wouldn't be clinched. We're bending that nail over to give us a good clinch on there.
Good clinch. Uh-huh. Oh, so the shoe stays tight.
Right.
Gotcha.
You gotta be careful, because you don't want to rasp your nails off. It's probably an okay shoe job. Right there.
Okay, now pull your hat off. I want to see if there's any beads of sweat on your head.
There's some sweat.
Look at this. Look at this. So we're talking, oh yeah, he's stout. He's stout. There's no question about it, man. So this is a good way not only to make a living, but to stay, get and stay in shape.
Yeah, it'll beat you to death if it doesn't keep you in shape.
All right, guys. We're going to take our last break here on this show, and when we come back, you know how we close our show. Usually Bryce is looking for me, and we're having a little fun.
This time, Goose.
Guess what, Rory? He's going to have to look for me.
I'm going to keep my eye on you.
All right, we'll be back in just a minute.
Hey, Rory, I know where he's hiding. He's trying to hide back there, but I know you're back there, Goose. Come on, finish the show off. You're not getting
All right. Time. Well, but before we close our show, Rory's got a cute little story he'd like to share with us, especially the young kids.
You stay right there.
All right.
I'm going to keep you in the camera this time.
Well, we were shoeing a horse one day. It was a big, strong horse. And the guy told me that if you have any problems shoeing her, to just let go of the leg and go to the next leg. Well, I was going to prove him wrong and prove that I could hold on to this horse. And she took that leg away so fast and so hard that she just sent me rolling and doing somersaults right out in front of her.
Just rolled right out there, huh? Now, what do you think about that, Goose? Hey, is he over there? He's trying to hide behind this horse. I know. He's over here. Ho, ho, ho. He got away. This is when he's not a goose, by the way, Rory. This is when he's a turkey.
This is a turkey.
Yeah. I'll bet he went out this door over here. Goose, I'm not going to be running off on another wild goose chase. Where are you, buddy?
I was a young troubadour.
I'm not going.
When I wrote on a song.
That's George, but that's not
George. Old troubadour.
George Strait? I didn't know you worked with celebrities here, Rory.
Just that one.
George Strait. Man.
Hey, have you ever done any celebrities?
No, not just George Strait.
I'm the first one.
You're the first one.
All right, baby. You know how we close our show, guys. Hey, it's a beautiful day out there. Look at that. Remember, we love you. We truly do.
Yes, we do.
Yes, we do. Hey, it's been a great show today. Thanks, man.
Thank you.
Hey, we'll catch you on our next show. See ya.